So this is a quick video on how the trace function works on lightburn. I actually came from Glowforge as well, so I've had a hard time understanding how to really get an image put where you want it to on the laser bed without having this visual overlay. So this is the Glowforge, obviously, like you can see here, where you're able to manipulate the image itself. The accuracy, little hit and miss on this. I usually give it a couple millimeters either direction just to be safe. So over to lightburn. So this is the area that we're working in. So this is our bed, everywhere where the grid is at. This time I'm doing these like little nested moons. So in lightburn you have a thing called frame. So you have both frame, the square frame, and then the circle frame. The circle frame actually, it'll basically trace the outermost parts of your shape. That's the most accurate one. The other one, the square frame, is good if you have just a flat sheet and you're really not trying to cut it super close. But it doesn't. It just gives you like a rough. It just gives you like a rough rectangle rather than a cutout that kind of hits all of the edges. So what I'm going to do is highlight this and then go over here, which is frame. And then as you can see I'm a little bit off. You can see the laser pointer there. So what that tells me is I'm going to have to move the image selection down just a little bit to make it work. It looks like I'm good everywhere else except for at the very top. So take my image here that I've got highlighted and then just bring it down a little bit. I'll put it right to there. Let's try that frame again. You can see it's tracing it out again. Looks okay so far. Yep. So everything is on the board. And that's basically it. So we know where it's going to go. Obviously a less complex pattern than this one would be a little bit easier to follow. And if you were in a smaller space, you can kind of just kind of watch it. But it's been good enough to where I can like take a stone or a small piece of wood and have it really centered right where I want it to be. And you know, you can keep adjusting it until it's exactly where you want it to be and there's no harm, no foul, because it's not actually burning anything. So turn the fan on and we'll go ahead and start. That's basically it. And off it goes. This isn't the fastest cut speed that I set it to, but for this particular type of wood that has a little bit of an issue cutting all the way through sometimes, I just go a little bit slower just to make sure that it cuts through. As you can see with the air compressor, there's no flashback on it at all, so it works really great even though it is a little bit slow. So that's it. Thanks for watching. If you have any questions, just let me know.